Hi, I'm Nolan Halliday, a Senior Solutions Engineer with SimScale. Today, we're going to walk through a tutorial where I show you how to set up and run an external aerodynamics CFD simulation on the SimScale platform. We'll leverage our Lattice Boltzmann solver to efficiently solve for the transient flow field using GPUs in the cloud. First, we'll create a virtual wind tunnel around the realistic car shape shown here. And then we will analyze the aerodynamic forces and moments on the vehicle. Let's go ahead and jump right into the SimScale platform in my web browser. Here we're going to set up the simulation and view some results. We start off in the SimScale dashboard. With the SimScale account, we have unlimited storage and virtually unlimited compute capacity. We'll see my project here as the Drive Air vehicle aerodynamics validation case. We can go ahead and launch right into this project. I've already run this analysis, so let's go ahead and look at some results first. Here we can see the 3D results live in my browser to better understand the aerodynamic efficiency of this vehicle. Surface values such as pressure or even near wall friction velocity can be plotted live in 3D. And using these results, we can already start to understand areas of high drag, flow jets, or flow separation. These can be useful for helping to optimize the aerodynamic shape of our vehicle. Section cuts can also be used to highlight local velocity and understand the flow patterns around our critical components, particularly in the underbody and the wake. Using our filters, we can toggle on and off various visual elements. We can store saved views. And we can even capture screenshots or animations for later use in a presentation. In fact, even transient results can be post-processed directly in the SimScale platform. And these give us a detailed understanding of the unsteady and shedding effects around the vehicle. This can have great ramifications on aerodynamic stability, as well as efficiency and wind-driven noise. Now, let's walk through how easy it is to set up a detailed aerodynamics analysis like this one in SimScale. Starting at the beginning, we would import a geometry either from our computer locally or from a CAD partner such as Onshape. I've already have some of these geometries imported into the project, and we can see here the various different configurations that we may want to analyze. We'll start with the fastback model, which was imported from an STL geometry file. We'll hit the blue button here to create a simulation, and you can see here that our incompressible LBM flow solver is available. At a high level, we recommend running the K-Omega SST DDES or IDDES turbulence model for simulations such as these. This gives you the best balance between accuracy and simulation speed. As we see our simulation tree here, many elements are already populated with default values. We can come in and modify any of these values to suit our needs, such as modifying our flow domain or changing our boundary conditions on our virtual wind tunnel. In this case, the validation was performed at 16 meters per second with very low turbulence intensity. The matching wind tunnel experiment used a rolling road, so we want to set up a moving wall with an X velocity matching that of our incoming flow speed, as well as define rotating wall boundary conditions for each of our wheels. I'll start with the front left wheel, and in SimScale, we have the ability to automatically center our axis on the selection, define the proper direction of our axis, right-hand rule, and define a rotational rate in either radians per second or RPM. After we've established our boundary conditions on both our wind tunnel and our rotating wheels, we will come in and edit the simulation controls for this particular analysis. At these speeds, we only need 7 seconds of runtime to establish periodic cyclical flow. So we can define the maximum runtime here as 7 seconds, which is a little shorter than the default 10 seconds. Additionally, we can calculate forces and moments acting on the vehicle under our result control section. We'll select our car surfaces. We can define a center of rotation, and we can define how much of the remaining transient simulation we want to use to calculate the averaging for the forces. For a lattice Boltzmann simulation, it's also a great practice to define the type of transient output we want to calculate as the run progresses. This is done to manage the amount of data that's consumed and also optimize the runtime for the simulation. So for this run, we could export the transient results on all the car surfaces. And we also could select any geometry primitives, such as local slices, or even a Cartesian box in space to output the results. Here, I'll just output the results on a centerline slice. Similarly, statistical average values for a time average of the transient data can also be selectively computed in order to maximize the efficiency of the simulation. In this case, I'll keep it simple and just output the average on the surfaces of the vehicle. Finally, we need to define our mesh resolution and other settings for the vehicle. Thankfully, SimScale makes this very easy, as we can use automatic mesh settings, a global fine to coarse level, a reference length that's either automatically generated based on your geometry or manually input. In this case, I'll use my wheelbase. And then a region of interest that will automatically refine my mesh near and project it in the streamwise direction from these surfaces. Additional refinements could be added based on geometry or surfaces. Now we can launch our simulation. By clicking the plus button next to the simulation runs, we can start a new simulation in the cloud. Once we kick this off, all we have to do is wait for an email in our inbox that lets us know that the simulation is complete. Because you're using SimScale, you can run multiple simulations at the same time. There's no need to wait for a queue or wait for one simulation to finish before you start the next. For example, I could change a boundary condition or rotate my wind tunnel to explore a slightly different yaw angle. And we can just kick off another simulation without having to wait for the first one to complete or for anybody to wait in a queue. Now, if at any point along the way you get stuck or you're not sure about something, you can reach out to us in our in-product chat. Down here in the corner of the screen, there's this blue button. You may have seen these before on other websites where you can talk to a salesperson, but in our case, we're actually using the in-product chat feature to reach out to simulation experts who are typically mechanical engineers with 5 to 10 years of simulation experience. With a professional license, your projects are 100% private. However, if you want to share your project with our support staff for direct feedback, you can just toggle this checkbox here below the chat, and our simulation experts will be able to give you direct feedback and check out your model. This concludes our demonstration using SimScale to quickly and accurately predict automotive aerodynamic performance. Thanks so much for your time today, and I look forward to seeing you in SimScale very soon.